Hi, this is Kayleen Herka, counseling psychologist and founder of Four Steps Up, and you are watching part 5 of video series on parenting mistakes. So this video is about emotional manipulation. What is emotional manipulation? Imagine I have a child and I am controlling my child by using my emotions. So my child wants to become a doctor and I cried, so he decided not to become a doctor. And my child wants to become engineer and I showed anger and I said, how can you become a doctor or engineer? Because I thought you will become a businessman and you will do CA. And he immediately thinks that he did some mistake and he is the cause of my pain, and so he have to change his opinions and he have to change options. And he will choose CA, not engineering or doctor, because he believes that he is responsible for my emotions. So what I will do is, I will show him my emotions. I will try to control his behaviors. So I will cry whenever he does something which is not acceptable to me. And I will be angry whenever he is doing something which is not acceptable to me. I will show my negative emotions whenever he is doing something not acceptable to me. And I will show positive emotions when... So many people talk about this part, but they don't talk about the other part. There is also a second part of emotional manipulation. That is nothing but showing positive emotions when the child is doing something that is acceptable. For example, my child said he will choose CA. Then I showed my happiness and I felt very happy. And my child got a medal and I started dancing. And my child achieved everything. So I started living happily. So this is second part. Because until or unless I show him that I can be happy when he succeeds, I cannot show him that I will be sad when he fails. So this is a complete package. But many therapists and many motivational speakers who ever talk about emotional manipulation, they talk only about negative emotions. That a person who tries to control other person by crying or by showing negative emotions, that is emotional manipulation. But that's a half part of the story. Other half is showing positive emotions when somebody is doing something which we want. And I will say that I am very proud of you, my child. You actually made my day today because you got first rank. I am feeling very happy. So I will also show, so with all my emotions, I will keep on controlling his behaviors. But here, what is wrong in this? Why I should not show my emotions? So generally, it is good to show emotions. It is good to express our emotions. It's better to be honest. Then what is wrong in this? If I show my emotions to my child and if I ask my child to do things according to that, what is wrong in that? Point is, in some of the cases, whatever emotions I show, those are fake in some of the cases. So parents manipulate children by showing fake emotions. So they don't actually feel that. For example, I'll say, I did lots of hard work and I bought this and you have to make use of this. But actually, I did not do much hard work. I just said that because I want my child to give respect to that, give value to that object which I bought. That's why I added up a story. This is one case. And in the other case, even if my emotions are true, I have to understand one thing. So based on emotions, if we take decisions, that is called emotional reasoning. Emotional reasoning is a cognitive error. Even if it is about me or my child, like I am asking my child to take decisions according to my emotions, or I am taking decisions according to my emotions, that is emotional reasoning. It's a bias, because emotions cannot decide what we have to do. Like for example, there is a family of one person, X, and he has a family. Family hates him. Then if I go and kill him, they will feel happy. But I can't kill him just because they will feel happy. And for example, in another case, this person X is a favorite to all the family members. They will cry after I kill this person. So then I will stop killing him. And if they are feeling happy, I will kill this person. So this is very inappropriate. Because Why? Because based on emotions, we cannot take decisions. We can express our emotions, we can understand our emotions, and based on our emotions, we can gain so much of self-awareness. For example, if I am feeling jealousy of something, that means I want it. And if I am feeling angry, I am feeling that somebody is violating my boundary. Like that, the emotional intelligence is very important. And I can gain self-awareness by using my emotions. I can make sense of my emotions and I can gain self-awareness. But apart from that, I should not use my emotions to take decisions. Why? Why? Because most of the times, emotions are not rational. So emotions are just emotions. But logics, thoughts are rational. So sometimes we might feel emotional it is logically wrong. For example, there is a person who needs to be hanged and he did many rapes and murders and I feel emotionally attached to him if he is my husband. So there will be like a tilting of the perception and there will be bias. So I feel attachment, I feel love for him even though he is a murderer. But logic says that he needs to be hanged. So here emotional reasoning is not going to help because emotions are emotions. They can help me in gaining awareness but not in taking decisions. So now these parents who control their children and make their children take decisions based on their emotions, what happens later is these children become vulnerable. They will start agreeing to anybody who shows negative emotions. Like for example, I had been training my child to obey my emotions. So after he grows up, he will go to a girl. That girl will say, I'll suicide if you actually don't marry me, if you don't love me, I'll suicide. Then he will agree. He will say, okay, fine, I love you. So like this, this person becomes a puppet. Based on how other people are feeling, based on how other people are reacting, this person will keep changing his decisions and his thoughts, everything. He will not have any moral system, ethical system of his own. He will not have any rationality of his own. He will keep behaving like a puppet in hands of people who show their emotions, either true or fake emotions, whatever they are. So now, if you are a parent who had been controlling your child by using your emotions, what you are supposed to do is, you have to learn other methods of controlling child if you really want to control, if there is need to control. And I'll be making another series of videos on parenting strategies you can watch. And apart from that, if this is your habit you learn from your parents or something like that, you have to work on this and you have to learn that you should not use your emotions to control people. You can express yourself, there is nothing wrong in that and it's good for you. And if you keep on expressing your true emotions, it's good for you. It makes you more authentic. But based on, for example, I am feeling sad that my child is going to another city. I can show my sadness, I can cry, then ask my child not to take decision based on my emotion. Take your own decision. Whatever is beneficial for you in the future, do that. But I am feeling sad, that is true. But that's okay. My sadness I will handle. And I will express my emotion and I will deal with this. And if you are a child who had been being emotionally manipulated by parents, or if you are now also, if you after becoming adult, if now also you are being controlled by other people, just because you cannot tolerate people feeling sad or something, then you need to work on that kind of pattern and you have to get yourself free from that. You have to learn how to tolerate when somebody is feeling sad or somebody feeling angry. It's okay to feel sad because sadness, anger, all these are emotions are part of our life. So always it's impossible to be happy. So 50% time will be happy, 50% time will be sad. That's okay. And you have to learn that kind of acceptance and then you will be resistant to emotional manipulation. And to watch other videos on different topics, subscribe to my channel, you'll get notifications. And you can also follow me on social media platforms so that you'll get all the updates. And thank you for watching.